So today we are going to discuss about festive season ad spend management. Now, festive season has kicked in and the whole Facebook ad dynamics change. The kind of responses that we receive, the kind of spend that we do on our campaigns, most part of the year, it is not going to be the same during this season, the festive season. Under festive season, there is a lot that we are going to cover today. We'll start with the current scenario. According to Economic Times, the festive season contributes a large chunk of advertising expenditure every year. It starts from Ganesh Chaturthi and the season peaks during Diwali and continues till Christmas. And during this season, the overall advertising expenditure for experience about 40% of spend of the overall year's expenditure within this period, within this festive season period. So that this is an information that I grabbed out of Economic Times. The trend goes like this. During this period, competition is higher than ever. Ad cost is also higher than ever since you pay, whatever you pay, it is determined by the competition. So the more the competition, the more the amount you'll have to bid to be seen on Facebook as a platform. Since Facebook limits ad inventories so that a user's newsfeed has more stories than ads, and Facebook limits the amount of content they see every day to be sure that it's more engaging. What this basically means is that any which ways, after this Cambridge Analytica and all the heat that Mark Zuckerberg has been facing, he has been facing throughout this year. This year has not been kind to him, is how I would like to put it. Any which ways, the overall ad space has got shrunk. During festive season, it gets even more little when it comes to accumulating or accommodating ads. So the more number of people trying to bid for the same amount of space means you have to bid more to be seen more by the relevant audience whom you want to reach. So that has been the trend. So that's about scenario. We'll talk about placement, mobile versus desktop. I would want to quickly share something here. So when we talk about mobile versus desktop, let me know if you are able to see the screen. Yes. Are you able to see the Quint image?
Yes.
Okay, right. So this image has been grabbed out of the Quint. It tells that India tops the highest when it comes to accessing Facebook on internet. Okay, it is the largest audience, the largest amount of audience who are accessing Facebook and WhatsApp through mobile. Number one is India, and then Indonesia, Mexico, Argentina, Malaysia. So 89% of audience on Facebook in India access Facebook via their smartphone, cell phone. So that gives us a gist. Okay, we will have to only and only focus on audiences who are consuming content on Facebook via their smartphones. So whatever we make, whatever we create, whatever we want to convey has to be done in a certain way that is optimized for a mobile or a smartphone. Okay, so that is the most important aspect to keep in mind during festive season, because whatever money you are about to spend, Facebook is always giving you an option of choosing the placement. Okay, if you go ahead and still choose desktop as a placement, even if they are only allotting 20% on a daily basis is a lot of money to shell out on an audience who are not going to be as responsive as the other 89% of the bunch, which is the mobile users, the users who access Facebook via mobile. So My suggestion to all of those who are going to see this recording or who are even viewing it live right now is that always optimize your content for smartphones, and also ensure that whenever you get an opportunity to choose the placement on Facebook, skip desktop and continue with only mobile as a placement option. So that is that. We'll move on. Right. You'll have to, as I said, there has to be an enhanced experience. Okay. Whoever is viewing your ad has to get an experience that stands out from all the other ads or all the other content that they are viewing on their Facebook newsfeed. And this is something that I have been telling since day one. I mean, this is something that has been continuously repeated by me during most of my conversations, even on online workshops and also on the recorded sessions. I have touched based on this point so very times. This is something that is of utmost importance, especially during festive season, because as I said, we tend to spend a lot more. However, if the content that we have come up with, if Facebook if we are able to communicate to Facebook that boss, this content is being liked by the viewers, or if we are able to convince Facebook that, you know what, this piece of content that we are promoting or we are posting, the users are engaging very well with this kind of content, then you do not have to spend as much to reach more audiences. When I say that, I am talking about CPM here. CPM is cost per 1,000 impressions. Okay. Lately, the campaign that I did, the video campaign that is, I have been experiencing a cost per 1,000 impressions pegged at 47 rupees. Okay. Whereas for a similar, for the same product rather, when I ran an image campaign, the CPM was pegged at 113 rupees. So you can understand that for a video, I am getting less than 50%. I'm able to reach the same amount of impressions at less than 50% the cost when I have a video running. So the better visual your content is, the better it gets engagement, the better the less you are having to spend on reaching more people or reaching more impressions.
But then, I mean, every time, what kind of video content can we create, especially from a real estate standpoint?
Okay. So you're still able to see my screen, right? Okay. So we are on fiverr.com. Most of you might know what Fiverr is. Basically, you can get things done for $5. Having said that, most of the stuff you don't get for $5 these days. Having said that, it has a very cool section here. Under video and animation, when you click on slideshows and promo videos, to the left, you can see that there is an option which says real estate promos.
Right.
Okay. When you click here, you get a lot of options to choose from. Okay, I have tried a couple of these. They are bang for the buck. I mean, I pay anywhere between $20 to $50 to come up with a video. Now that is not much, to be very honest with you. But having said that, with the kind of with the way the rupee is falling in front of dollar, is going to we are going to mind it soon. But for now, I think even a single conversion takes care of all these spends that we do. And at the same time, let's say a $30 spent on creating a video via this platform. If we are able to reach more number of audiences at a lesser cost per 1,000 impression, then we are also saving on that. Okay, so it is a gamble that we should take, because at the end of the day, as I've said, if we are able to enhance the experience of the users, we are going to win, because Facebook is then going to promote our ad for us. at lower cost.
So this
is one cool method of doing it. This is something that I wanted to share for a long time. I think this is a perfect timing. So again, fiverr.com, under video and animation, you click on slideshows and promo videos. And under slideshows and promo videos, you have something called real estate promos.
Right.
There you can, every time I want to do something, I either select level 2 or top level seller. It reduces the option, but then I am only left with people who are
really good.
The professionals.
Right.
That is how you select. You can also give the new timers a chance if that is something that you want to do. Or you can probably also filter as per the price range. And if you're looking for something quick, you can just select the delivery timeline and you'll get a list of people who will get something done for you within 24 hours. A lot of things to choose from here. I hope that answers your questions, Chandraji.
Yeah, absolutely. Thanks for that.
Great. Similarly, like I said, if you're able to improve your cost per 1,000 impressions, automatically your cost per click and the click-through rate also gets affected. The cost per click is the cost that you pay to Facebook for every click that you receive on your ad that takes the audience or the viewer of the ad to a landing page or to any other asset that you want them to take to. Okay, and click-through rate again is a very critical metric that I always like to measure, because if I'm spending, let's say, 47 rupees for every 1,000 impressions, and of the one, so let's say for example I've spent 50 rupees for 1,000 impressions, and which means I'm spending approximately 5 rupees to reach 100 people. Now, how many of the 100 people are going to click on the ad or going to show interest? The primary interest on the ad is of utmost importance for me, because behind every 5 rupees that I'm spending to reach those 100 people, I want to know out of the 100, how many people are actually interested in my product. Okay, so that is how I determine the effectiveness of my ad. So if my CTR is anything more than 5%, which means let's say, for example, 50 rupees for 1,000 impressions, which means 5 rupees for 100 impressions. And if my click-through rate is 5%, that would mean that I'm spending 1 rupee behind every person who is showing interest in my ad. Now, that is a pretty decent spend. With every rupee spent is going to get, if it's returning me an interested candidate or an interested prospect, I'm happy to have that kind of a metric running for me. So that is about enhancing experience, guys. Always ensure that you keep enhancing the experience of the viewer of your ad, because the better they engage, the better your ad is going to perform, the lower you are going to pay to reach as many people on Facebook as possible. Right. We'll also discuss about the campaign objective. During festive season, this becomes really tricky. Right now, as I said, for a lead generation ad, the cost per 1,000 impressions have skyrocketed. Okay. You're paying, I don't know, the last I checked, we are paying north of 100 rupees to reach 1,000 audience, impressions for a lead generation ad. Whereas if you select the campaign objective as traffic or reach, you're spending considerably low because the objective is helping you reach more and more people, and it is not optimized for getting an engaged getting engaged with your audience to collect their leads. Having said that, it is a very tricky kind of a situation here. If you do not have an equally appealing asset to take them to, like a highly convertible microsite or something, running traffic and reach ads just for the sake of it is not going to give you better results. If you want to lower your ad spend, you should always ensure that you have a highly converting landing page, microsite, or a website at the back end. So that is going to ensure that you reach more audience who are eventually going to click on that button, and they are taken to one of these assets that you have built for yourself, and conversion happens outside of Facebook. Okay, if that is not an option for you as of now, then continue to work with lead gen ads, continue to enhance the experience, as I said. Try including videos in your lead generation ad, because if people start engaging, if they start liking your content, if they start sharing your content, or if they comment on the ad copy, then Facebook understands that the ad is doing better, and it has a visual appeal. So it starts showing the ad to more people, and eventually your cost per lead will come down. Okay. So again, if you have a highly converting asset, then try traffic and reach ads over lead generation right now, because that is going to help you lower the cost per lead. If you do not have anything of that sort, then stick with lead gen. But when you do that, ensure that you enhance the experience of the viewers of the ad. Okay. Audience. Right. This is another crucial thing. Okay. Now, as we all by now have understood that, boss, at this time of the year, there are a lot of people who want to advertise their products, and everyone thinks that their product is special, and if they spend on reaching out to more and more people, they are going to get amazing conversions. Okay, there is no harm in thinking like that. Everyone who's on Facebook or any other ad platform for that matter during this season has something worthwhile to promote. Having said that, it is very, very, very crucial to understand what is the engagement ratio. What is how are you going to get most buck for your money? We will quickly talk about the buyer journey here. When you're targeting new audience, when you're targeting audience who have not come across your product or project or page before, you are taking them from an unaware stage to a problem aware stage. Okay, so these are going to be your virgin audiences who do not know that there is a project called Vaishnavi Estates exists. Okay, they don't know about it, and they don't know if they are interested in investing in a property called Vaishnavi Estates. They are unaware. Okay, and by showing them the ad, what you are doing is that you're telling them ki baba, there is this project that exists, and you should probably consider investing in this project. So you're taking them from unaware to problem aware stage. That is what you are doing with the audience. If you are only targeting new, virgin new audiences at this point of time. But if you have already engaged with an audience for a certain period of time, let's say for example, this ad that I was running. A good example is that these days I have been showcasing that video views metrics on my Learn Real Estate Marketing group. A particular video for a project that has got more than 50,000 views already. So there are for that particular campaign of mine, I have already accumulated an audience of 50,000 people who have viewed the video for 10 or more seconds, which means I have already taken them from an unaware to a problem aware stage. And now if I engage with them, I am going to give them a solution. I mean, they're going to then graduate to the solution aware, product aware, and fully aware stage. Okay. So me spending, so let's say for example, I have 1,000 rupees to spend during this festive season. It is going to be better for me to spend it with an already engaged audience, because they already know about me. When they know about me, I am going to be able to engage with them more smoothly during this season. So
you are running retargeting ads, is it, typically with your custom audience?
During this season, it is advisable that I am currently not running anything. But during this season, if I am going to be given an option, I will create a custom audience of those 50,000 people who have viewed that video. And then I will show them another video or give them some other experience. So that is better for me to do during festive season, because those guys already know about the product. And since, so let's say, for example, I ran an ad and only the ones who are interested in investing on that property or wanted to know more about that property viewed it for more than 10 seconds. So I now know that there are 50,000 people out there who know what Kalyan Nagari is and where it is located, what are the amenities, how is the connectivity, everything. So now during this time where the competition is high, there are a lot of people trying to reach out to the same kind of audiences. If I take my product and engage with the same audience again, chances of me getting that conversion is higher than just targeting newer audience. So instead of I also doing the same thing that others are going to do, I would just engage with the audience whom I have engaged with previously during the non-peak season or during the okay kind of season. So that is how it is. I mean, all of this that we are talking about here, it is how this should be ideally practiced. Having said that, I understand that most of us are still starting out. Okay. So, but this is a good learning experience for us. So if we start preparing for the festive season right ahead, like let's say for example in India, festive season kicks in during Ganesh Chaturthi. But if we start preparing for our festive season a month ahead of Ganesh Chaturthi, during Ganesh Chaturthi, we will also have a scenario where we have already engaged with a sizable amount of audience and all we have to do is reach to them again and again with fresh content, with something that they would like to see and they would relate to because they've already seen and liked it earlier. Right? Okay. So that's about the audience. So yeah, I mean, it is during festive season, it is always advisable that you interact more with the engaged, already engaged audience as against new audience. Okay. That is what I wanted to convey here. And finally, the universal truth. Yeah. So, yeah, I mean, this is something which is very important. And this is not just for the festive season rush. This is for us to always and always remember every time we sit down to create a campaign or to judge how a campaign has performed or to get some knowledge out of it. These are the things that we should always have in our mind. People remember stuff that has left an impact on them. Okay, so if you are able to leave an impact on someone, even after you go back and show the same ad to them 6 months later, if you have been successfully able to have that impact on the first go, they will tend to remember you even after 6 months.
Right.
Okay, so that is the magic of leaving an impact. If you leave an impact, people will never forget you. Now, there is a downside to that. We will talk about the downside. Everyone talks about leaving an impact, which is doing an amazing job. But on Facebook, it has a lot of downside. So if you don't innovate, if you don't continuously innovate or create something new or create something fresh, you are not going to get a different response. So as they say, if you're expecting a different response, you have to do things differently. You cannot do the same thing again and again and expect a different kind of response, right? So let's say, for example, with my video ad that I ran, 50,000 people got engaged. It has created an amazing impact. I cannot take the same video now and engage with the same audience. Because if I do that, I'm not going to get a different result out of it. I'll have to take that engagement that I have created with this audience to the next level, which means I'll have to constantly improve and take fresh approach to get better results.
True.
Right? So, I have shown them a video. They have liked it. It's amazing. I've got responses. I've got calls, everything. Now is the time when I have to actually capitalize on that audience and get them get them to do something more for me. When such a time comes, if I show them the same video that I have shown them earlier, it is not going to get me a better result. Rather, what I will do is that of whatever inventories that I've sold with the help of that video, I am going to do a short 2 or 3 minute testimonials with people who have booked after having a look at that ad. I will create a video of those testimonials and then I'll promote that testimonial to these 50,000 people. Now that is giving them a better experience, because in that testimonial video, what people are going to say that I was going through my Facebook social feed when I came across this eye-catchy video about Kalyan Nagari. After going to through 60 seconds of the video, we kind of liked what we saw. Hence, we decided to do a site visit. When we were at the site, we were effectively managed and we were given proper information. We saw that the lawn was already built and most of the amenities were ready to use. And since there were not many inventories to choose from, we decided to take the plunge right away. It was an amazing experience right from when we saw the video till we gave the check or we booked the flat. So they are going to talk about the video that they saw once or twice within the testimonial, and that is going to create an impact the second time around when I take the fresh approach to the same audience, right? So that is what it is. I mean, again, I will go through all the 3 points again for everyone to understand properly that creating an impact is good, but creating an impact and trying to again create an impact with the same thing that you with the same tool that you used to create an impact in the first place is not going to help. You'll have to take the next step. You'll have to constantly improve yourself and take a fresh approach to get better results out of the same audience.
Right.
Okay. Also, you know, our creative approach holds this key to our success. Okay. And this is also something that I wanted to discuss based on the experiences that I have had. So most of the marketers, advertisers on Facebook look at, you know, campaigns and ad management in a certain way. They look at it as if ye product hai, isko market mein leke jayenge, to is product ke balbute mein humko response milega. Which means depending on how good or bad the product is, we will get response from the market. I don't want to talk about any other communication channel or marketing channel here, but in Facebook, that is not true. Okay. Product project does not matter. I mean, it can be good, it cannot be good or whatever it is. But on Facebook, it is always the experience that we are promoting that matters and not the product that we are promoting. Okay. So it is very important for us to remember this very crucial point, guys. On a platform such as Facebook, which is a social media platform in which people, log in or people enter to see what their friends, colleagues are doing. It is very important that we create experiences for them to remember. Okay, great. Yeah. So, let me put this point across once again. As a platform, Facebook reacts to things very differently. Okay. It is not the product or the project that is going to define the performance of your campaign. It is purely the experience that you are going to create and promote that is going to define the success and failure of your campaign. Okay. Your audience knows who you are, what you do, and what you have on offer. It is how you are going to, or how the thing is going to impact their lives, is going to determine how good your ad campaign is going to perform. So this is, and again, as I said, whatever we are discussing under universal truth, it is not only specific to this festive season rush. It is for us to remember always. Okay. On Facebook, it's the experience. As I said, go for a video as against an image. Go for something that is going to be more engaging. You have to create, I mean, you have to start right up there, and then you have to take that engagement to the next level. And the reputation of your project, the brand name is not something that is going to help you improvise every time. It will probably help you to set yourself up for the first time, But after that, all of this is not going to help. You'll have to always up your game and ensure that you give top-notch experience again and again to have that conversion and to help get results that you want to get out of Facebook as an ad platform. Final point, the thought process. And this is an extension of what we have spoken till now. You'll have to engage first and then build your brand later. Okay. I've seen many people coming to me and saying that, you know what, ye falana developer hai, they have a very nice name in the market. They have been there for 40 years and this and that. We ran a campaign for them. And then we parallelly, we also ran a campaign for this small time channel partner. The audience was same, everything was same. For the channel partner, we were able to generate leads at less than 100 rupees. But for this brand, we've spent more than 5,000 rupees, but we have not able to generate any lead. The only thing that I always tell to such people and to whoever comes to me sharing this information is that it really does not matter if you are a brand or not. On Facebook, it is the experience that matters. If you are able to give superior experience, you are going to get better results. Being a brand, if you are not able to deliver a decent enough experience, you are still going to fail on Facebook. Okay, it is a push strategy platform. Okay, your ads are pushed to people who might or might not want to see you at that point of time. If you are able to create an experience that is going to help change their mind, even if they are not interested, and if you are able to create an experience that will change their mind, that is when you win on this platform called Facebook, when you are running ads there. So that is one final thing that I wanted to add. Thank you so much. I think I have done covering my points, and I'm here to take questions right now.